The concentration in the dairy industry has changed over the years. There are many more extremely large farms milking thousands and even tens of thousands of cows these days.
4 months ago, this barn was full of animals of all ages, and there was probably over 300
in
here in this barn during the winter months. It's really quiet in here now.
I think the decision to sell the cows had been building for some time. I mean, we really hadn't been doing well for several years.
Your big farms are growing, and that doesn't help your small farms, because we can't grow as big as these bigger farms.
And Connecticut doesn't have the land that out west or Midwest has for farms to expand.
My father would get groups of farmers and go to the legislative building, and we'd all fight for agriculture.
There's less and less farmland available to us every year. I'm 10th generation at least, so I wanted to take over the farm and continue the farming legacy.
One of our problems over the years has been the cycle in milk prices. The price of milk is set by the federal government, and it's basically figured on a nationwide basis. So we in Connecticut are at a disadvantage compared to farms in some other areas of the country where they have lower property taxes, lower energy costs, lower labor costs, and we're competing in the same marketplace with the same price of milk. I'm 69, my brother's 66. We're tired of working for no money.
Small dairy farms you're closing down. So we've diversified. My mother's name is Kristen, and she runs the creamery side. I run the dairy side. We scoop ice cream. We have a corn maze, and it changes every year. You get a game sheet, go into that corn maze, and you learn a little bit about dairy.
In an area where there are very few farms, it's important to connect with the public, to tell your story, or somebody else will tell it for you.
Sometimes it feels like a failure because I wasn't able to continue the farm, you know. After 10 generations.
My father had committed suicide in March. He was sick. It was a lot going on for him, and he couldn't take it anymore. He was hurting.
He thought that the medical bills would just bring the farm down, and with a bad year, he just decided that it was better to be without him.
If I can mention anything, seek help. Seek help, seek help, seek help. My boyfriend and I, Jared, came home from college. The plan is for us to take over and for our kids to be the next generation.
I am definitely hopeful. I think there's opportunities out there for me. I'm in the process of deciding what the right step is.